I've unmuted you. But we can't see the video, we can't even hear the voice. What's happening there?
Okay. Yeah, just starting.
Let me see your plate.
It's mommy that is talking about.
I also want to welcome our guy from the college, Dr. Olashe. You are welcome, sir. God bless you. As you know, there are people to be introduced to do that with people. God bless you.
We are grateful.
Everyone, you're all welcome once again to the celebration of life. All before the celebration of life of our daddy. And quickly, to take the first picture of the celebration of the beginning, John 14, verses 1 to 4. I want to call Shalom, one of the children, to take that. Shalom.
Oh,
How do you know? It's well for our food. Now we're going to have the dialogue on our God. The vision are ready. I will do at the screen and your vision for the biography of our agriculture. Family members and friends from outside of his nuclear family
I'm touching you that you remain with him for the rest of his life. In addition to having a vibrant social talent, Ruben Mabosha was academically successful from his early years. He attended All Saints Primary School, Oshodi, and obtained the first school leaving certificate in December 1962. He had a secondary school education at Oshodi Grammar School, Oshodi, between 1963 and 1967. Before joining a private college in Lamu, where he obtained his high school certificate. He seemed to have a clear understanding about his career path until early in life, as his first job was as a teacher at Otani Maju Secondary School, Otani Maju. He also taught briefly at St. Lawrence's Grammar School in Asia, 1972 to 1973, and Victory College in Canada, 1973 to 1974. Olubun Mabosha graduated from the University of Dubai in 1972 with a BSc Honours degree in Agriculture. He also obtained an MSc in Food Technology from South London University, UK, and an MSc in Urban Studies from University of Dubai, UK. In the year 2013, he obtained his PhD in Management Science from Nigeria Technical University of Technology, Obomoso, Nigeria. Dr. Obomoso was an influential leader and successful academic. He served as head of the Department of Food Technology at Kaduna Polytechnic from October 1981 to September 1985, before moving to Nara College of Technology, Nigeria's premier higher educational institution in 1987. At Nara College of Technology, he served military as the head of the Department of Food Technology, chairman and senior staff association, national president, Food Technology Staff Association in Nigeria, post the director of the School of Applied Sciences, deputy rector, academics, and the two-time rector of the college, 2001 to 2009. As rector, he instituted many reforms and projects that included the establishment of Center for Entrepreneurship Development, Center for Applied Research and Technology Innovation, the Internal Quality Assurance Unit, and the Satellite Unit, as well as a satellite campus of the college in the state for agricultural programs and the Students Development Center. His passion for industry higher education collaboration led to the admission of Yaba College of Technology as the first educational institution corporate member of both the Nigeria Association of Small and Medium Enterprises and the Nigeria South Africa Chamber of Commerce. The National Office for Technology Acquisition and Promotion, NOTA, also designated the college as an intellectual property technology transfer office, ITO, to promote international and strengthen the linkage between educational research institutions and industries. At the age of 62, he was nominated by the federal government of Nigeria's representative for the position of Secretary General, Chief Executive Officer of the Commonwealth Association of Technical Universities and Polytechnics in Africa, Nairobi, Kenya, where he served from March 2012 to December 2018. As the Secretary General of CAPA, he is responsible for the overall management of the organization, various project initiatives and strategies, as well as activities that successfully promoted partnerships and capacity building in technical and vocational education and training, TVOs, entrepreneurship education, applied research and innovation, and policy advocacy for the development of adequate skilled technical manpower, job creation, and industrial development in CAPA member countries. Over the years, experiencing various professional qualifications, including certificate in digital credit and small enterprise development, awarded by the Israeli Center for International Development and African Development Finance Institutions. July 2000, certificate in microeconomic policy analysis, April 1998, and certificate in poverty alleviation policies and strategies, September 2000. Both awarded by the National Center for Economic Management, Nigeria, and certificate in innovation for economic development, Harvard Kennedy School, USA, April 2016. He was a fellow of the Nigerian Institute of Food Science and Technology, 2000. Fellow Academy for Entrepreneurial Studies, Nigeria, 2008. And fellow Nigeria Institute of Management, 2015. He served on the executive board of several national and international organizations that included the Commonwealth Consortium for Education, CCFE, the World Federation of Colleges and Polytechnics, WFCP, and the Coalition on Media and Education for the Development Africa Forum, CAFO, based at the headquarters of the African Union Commission in Addis Ababa. CAFO's mission is to promote communication as a core element of education and youth development that will focus on reforms and skills development to enhance the participation of youths and help the workforce, particularly in Africa's agricultural sector. We also serve as a technology management consultant and development practitioner on the board of directors of Techno-Based Africa Consulting. Dr. Obocha was decorated in August 2012 by the President of the Federal Republic of Nigeria with a national honor, the National Productivity Order of Merit, NPOM. For his outstanding contributions to human resource development in Nigeria. Dr. Obocha was a committed family man who modeled family deal. Time would demand for him unusual strength and courage when his wife, Mrs. Folashade Tayo Obocha, died on July 6, 1998. He raised six children, while he remained steadfast along his career path. He remained in Nigeria for 10 years before getting married in 2008 to Mrs. Jokulari and Bradley Williams, also a successful academic and an accomplished staff of Ghana Holding Technology. Umu Obocha was also a very committed Christian. Your preservation didn't testify to the abundant grace of God as the source of all his achievements, which led to the achievements of all his life goals, except one, and was determined on top of insanity to put the rest of his life to glory in the knowledge of God, his will, his service, and evangelism. He began to register for a Bible college program. He never failed to act by the grace of God. Whenever I talked about any plans of those we had, he was very passionate about living out the Christian faith through acts of charity and welfare, a very able tool for the growth of the early church, Acts 2, 44 to 47. His service to the Almighty God was a very important part of his life. He was a member of the Foursquare Coastal Church, National Headquarters Church at Nyalabuyi, Yama, and was also a founding member of the Sanctuary of Grace, the Foursquare Coastal Church, Yama Tech area, which was established on December 17, 2000. He also sold to the church in our areas to be used as a temporary stop for church equipment, and his home remains our home and love center today. He really gave us time and resources to the work of the Lord, particularly towards welfare, missions, and church growth. At the time of this passing, he was the chairman of the welfare committee of the Foursquare Coastal Church, Yama Tech. He gave cheerfully to the church's missions outreach. His philanthropic nature ended him to the Foursquare Students' Church, Yama Tech, which is supported on an annual basis to further the work of the kingdom on campus. He was the primary chairman of the David Olukale Gwabili Educational and Vocational Endowment Committee, now the David Olukale Gwabili Foundation, set up in honor of the late pioneer pastor of the First Pentecostal Church, Yamatech area. The foundation was established as an outreach arm of the church, which serves to identify and provide financial, technical, and strategic assistance to individuals who need support in their educational or vocational endeavor. During his time as chairman, he developed a policy to guide the committee towards the achievement of set goals. He also partnered with the Council of Foursquare CFM to organize a program entrepreneurship in order to follow the goals of the committee, with subsequent grants given to the deserving recipients.
The sun was shining across the river, and you'll never be happy again.
The world mission is the story of creation and a man with a ministry of activists. He was appointed the chairman of the Talks Expansion Project at number 14 in the Toronto Street and British Yapan Lagos in 2019. Under his watch, the job secured an additional property for our expansion project. He remained dedicated to the North's work on the discussion and was even appointed as a Speaker of the Father's Day Service on June 21, 2020. Dr. Mugno was a leader in the life of sacrifice, generosity, love, humility, kindness, and care for the welfare of others. His life remains an inspiration to all who knew him. His passion for the development of Africa through advancement in technical and vocational education remains a legacy worth pursuing. He will be soul next. May soul rest in perfect peace in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen.
Across the bridge, there's more sorrow. Across the bridge, there's more pain. The sun is shining across the river, and you'll never be again. Across the bridge, there's more sorrow. Across the bridge, there's more pain. The sun will shine across the river, and you'll never be again.
Thank you, Father. We are going to be taking the second story for 1 Thessalonians verse 4. 1 Thessalonians chapter 4, from verses 13 to 18. And I'll be calling on one of the sons of our daddy, Brother Alaba. Scripture was today taken from the book of 1 Thessalonians chapter 4, from verse 13 to 18. But I will not have you to be ignorant, brethren, concerning them which are asleep, that he sorrow for us, even as others which are broken. For if we believe that Christ died and rose again, even so, then also we sleep in Jesus. For this we say unto you by the word of the Lord, that we which are alive and remain unto the coming of the Lord shall not prevent them which are sick. For the Lord himself shall descend from them a shout, the voice of the archangel, and with the trump of God, and the dead in Christ shall rise first. Then we which are alive and remain shall be brought up together with them in the cloud to meet the Lord in the air, and so shall we ever have to the Lord. Therefore, comfort one another in these words. The Lord will be with you.
Hey, hey, oh, hey. Thank you.
is a special person to be a father, a friend, a counselor, a confidant, a deed, a good man. We are also going to pray for you. We just started the simple two of the day and introduced you to me as a young man who will be able to follow God. And together, we join him and follow the Lord. God help us and God help us to know. It's a transformational life. We do things that we all want to do in the life of somebody who loves God. It's a transformational journey. We took it through the action. The first step was when Sister Shari left us. When Sister Shari left us, they had to balance going with the Lord, with making up the children, and God helped him that he was able to stay through. He stayed through stormy waters. Many things compared to him, but yet God helped him to stand. The second transformational theater was when Sister Shari took the glorious. When she joined us, she became like a beam of light that helped him. He continued going, doing the work of God, being rejected in the world, hospitality, and seeing that everything goes on well, most especially in the church of God, the sacred workplace, the sacred God, the sacred workplace, the sacred God, the time and treasure. He never intended to work across the children, the women, the men. He was a significant. Someone that is prepared for us, our elder. But they are being in the worship group, teaching us from the school, taking part in home and having this trip. By the time the church started in 2005, the day we still for the people to be what we have no place, then the job of every graduate of the church. He transformed the required gathering months to a foundation that are being scholarship to 14 people. Before the intervention started in the country, the was appreciated by meeting in the church. This 78th Baptist series was a blessing to the church. God of God, I will miss you. The church of God will miss you. My children will miss you. And the investment that you give in the life of children, my children, the children of the church, and your own children will not be blessed in Jesus' name. By the grace of God, we all would like the children to be able to fulfill what we want them to do. Good people, better people in life. They're not used to you to talk so many lives. And I believe God that you are resting in His bosom. Who let the children in the bosom? I will definitely miss you. The church of God will miss you. My family will miss you. I know your children will miss you much more. And the fact that we miss you. The chapter of this will make the sacrifice of grace that you want them to be in the name of Jesus. And I know by now, it will be like a day to be rejoicing. The two of you have met, and your son together will be adding our and the moral work. Your name will be good night, good night, good night.
This is a non-functional organization whose mandate is supporting professionals as skilled development as well as promoting policy and advocacy, the favor of technical and vocational education and training in Africa. Our beloved Dr. Rubin International was by the special grace of God, the Secretary General of the Nairobi-based Commonwealth Association of Technical Universities and Polytechnics. Kaba. How important Kaba is in Africa development is not the agenda, it's not the agenda of this meeting, but it was the worldwide association. Our beloved Bonnie was very much involved in any aspect of technical development in our universities and College of Technologies. With that sincere commitment to work externally, the work great commitment and the work to simply become a worldwide body across the continent of Africa and beyond. The Commonwealth Conference of Education held on the 7th of March 1977 out in Accra, Ghana, the Commonwealth Ministers of Education have realized the need for an association that will promote the development of the curriculum and to produce the required technical skill and manpower for the socio-economic development of its member countries. And our beloved brother was so much and so outstandingly found to seek that position at this located in Nairobi, Kenya. He worked there for many years and his really sacrificed and was there to represent not just Nigeria, but the whole of the continent in that capacity for a long time. I have privileged to work with him in church. He has many times been our very noble chairman of some of the projects we organized in the Yaba district at that time, and his commitment relating to be part of the team that moved into growing spiritual revival of the Yaba College of Tech that led finally by the special grace to the formation of the church, which is referred to as Yaba Tech First Grand Gospel Church in Abule, Ojia. For me, was such a close and very eloquent, beautiful, relational person. Whom perhaps I cherish our discussions every time I see you together. Whom you may not feel a sense of grandeur, a sense of enrichment of his humor and of his status, does not bring him to any group of people he is. Is a huge mobilizer to the great festivals and very, very much capable in whatsoever commitment he put into his hands. He worked very, very seriously with our dear Reverend Ayumi, a blessed number two, and they all came and started the church, established the church, which perhaps we are in. And celebrating his memory and his for me, nothing is hard, nothing is too much. No tax that you receive that perhaps you feel that it is something that it cannot be done. And I know some people around me, even when I was in jail, as well, and I love the encouragement to give to me as a person who most of the time is shared. I believe that the special grace of God has made some impact in the educational sector and even with us in the church in the social, cultural, as well as the religious sector. And I remember that many times he was a curator of the Yaba College of Technology, and by the special grace of God, I was looking forward to becoming the first vice chancellor in the initial intent God brought to pass. He finished well, he stood firm, he started building capacities in the church, and by the special grace of God, he was very devoted to what he was coming to his hands. To be missing, but by the special grace of God, I mean for a short while. Because the Bible tells us we should not weep as the heathens do, but we should. We will create fullness of joy in our hearts. We look forward to our coming together very soon and to the past and to eternity when the trump of God shall sound. The Bible says, "Dead in Christ shall rise first, and those of us who are alive will be changed in the inquiry of our heart, and shall forever be with the Lord." 1 Thessalonians chapter 4, reading from verse 16 to 18. I believe that that period is so close that I want to believe that each and every one of us should want to wear our tears and we should look forward to that glorious coming together. We are extending our sympathy and not only sympathy, we express our compassionate spirits and thoughts to their wife and the children, and without any misadvice, we believe that on that day we shall meet to part no more. Let's take a share with this. Let's look forward at the little things or the tidbits we have learned of him and have seen of him before the amplified by many whose lives he has touched. And having taught their lives, they will continue by the special grace to our hearts, and his memory will remain everlasting and ever great. The land of us and amongst us. May his gentle soul rest in peace, and may the joy of the Lord be the portion of each and every one of us who have known him, and keep steadfast in faith, and without any reason for the belief that God Almighty will grant every one of us in the sweet comforts of the resurrection, when he will appear in his hand and shall be joined together with his saints.
Was very, very unique, silent, light of There are many in the body of Christ who are young. He was mass, she said. Many who are dead, he was here, she said. And many who are dead, he was sweet, she said. Without making any announcements, he was silently contributing to the development and growth of the body of Christ, financially, physically, spiritually. It's really a big mess. I would say, as far as the body of Christ is concerned, we have lost a gallant soldier in the army.
Consisting of some of the intelligence,
helping, counseling, developing, supporting, and caring for one another. Global kind, accommodating, hospitable, humble, and very respectful. Your taking of your signal together, and what we talk, the mental and the body, was uncompromisable, and was introduced to the area. And the supporters, just looking at the commercial views and how to establish relationship with Christ. As I knew was going to be able to do this one, he dedicated his love to the love and peace of God, and he offered this world as a believer, which is comforting to us. Hopefully, you will have a time to do the worship and continue to grace.
Sunday worship service. I pray that God who accept him to the church of God will control his church and will control his family in the name of Jesus. And I know that every group in the circle of this have enjoyed his service, and we pray that God will continue to bless the church in the name of Jesus.
His wisdom was quite fantastic. He is a lover of people and is a helper to so many people. When I was opportuned to be in a committee meeting, that is the JOA Foundation, his contributions were very excellent. And while not even in the country, he would always send me a text. And his unity is exceptional. He would address me, you know, he should be at that age. He should be remembered by that. He could pass as a guy. But I'll tell you, he will still respect me. Yes, and he will still accord me all the necessary respect. You know, his unity is quite fantastic. Thank you, Pastor. I will miss you. The entire family too will miss you. The rest of the person of our Lord.
The destiny of this son, the Lord Jesus, to help one of the things of his life, to help one to be fulfilled to faith and devotion, that is true, God Jesus to be in our lives. To more of our mission and also to my siblings and their families, to come this by devotion, and we will be able to use.
Shall say unto the Lord, all you have to see is the Lord. For all of us, in the center of the preliminary committee, we say that the worship will miss you. Move back, continue to rest in the bosom of our Lord until you come in the back of the world. Move back, will miss you.
But Dr. Wilson is a man of people, a great man, a man with a large heart, lover of children. Time without number, Dr. Wilson in his lifetime. Anytime he saw me with my children, he would encourage me and tell me in Yoruba language, Madam, and my dear, I know of you. In our red shirt. And this word gave me a kind of encouragement that I'm doing the right thing. To God be the glory for me. The life was strength. He will miss you, that in your worship, sleep on in the bosom of the Lord Jesus Christ, your Savior, in Jesus' name.
I said, He was a brilliant woman, very intelligent. He had great passion for excellence. He was proven to everyone that came across him. He was a diligent worker, resilient. As a friend of the family, he was a very loyal father, caring, kind. I know that Dr. Mwacha has gone to sleep to meet the Lord because he died as a believer. I believe so. I do, Dr. Mwacha.
Our institutions are
taught very well the passion.
Praise the Lord. I'm supposed to do the job for about 15 minutes. Please, Senior Pastor, give me a signal. As the first one, we can know I can be there for the next one now. So after spending about 13 minutes, please give me a signal. Praise the Lord. I know. There is a shaking heaven. There is a shaking heaven. Do you know that there is a shaking heaven?
that our brother is only away from us for a while, because there's going to be another fellowship in heaven. We shall be to one more. For the meantime, Lord, we will encourage ourselves. Keep on running the race until we hear as he has heard. Well done, thou faithful servant. Enter into the rest of your master. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Amen.
Since it's going to be a short exhortation, let's quickly take our text from Revelation chapter 14, verse 13. And the topic of this short exhortation is just a moment. What do I say?
Just a moment.
Revelation 14, verse 13. I will read. And I heard a voice from heaven saying unto me, write, blessed are the dead which died in the Lord from henceforth. Yea, seeth the Spirit, that they may rest from their labors and their works do follow them. May the Lord bless the things in hearing and the assimilation of his words in Jesus' name. Life is so short, death is so short, health is so weak, and heaven is so real. But one assurance I have in my spirit is that God will be made in heaven. May we all make it in Jesus' name.
Amen.
In that particular verse, the word of God says, blessed are the dead which die in the Lord. While he was here on earth, he was blessed, according to some word, from verse 1 to 3. Blessed is the man who does not walk in the counsel of the godly, nor stand in the way of sinners, nor sit in the seat of the scornful. But his delight is in the law of the Lord, and in the law does he meditate day and night. And he is like a tree planted by the rivers of water, whatsoever he sleeps, that do not wither, and whatsoever he lays his hands upon, he shall prosper. This is the picture of brotherhood whom we are celebrating today. In life, he was blessed. In death, he was also blessed. Because part of his blessing, according to that verse, is that he will rest from his devil. At the end of our lives, may we all secure that rest in the name of Jesus. If only I can imagine, if only we can hear him speak, he will say something like, I am free. Free from never. Free from labor postal. Free from driver's problem. Free from calm down. Knock in, knock out, knock up. He's free with the soul, spirit, and body. But to us, he said to us, do not weep for me, do not mourn for me. I am in the bosom of the Lord. And so there will he be till we shall meet him when our life ends here on this side of eternity in the name of Jesus. What sort of thing will happen? There are worries. We will be about the right. But have we forgotten the word of God that says, he is the husband, only widow. We worry about the children, forgetting that God is the father of not just the fatherless, he's also the father of the orphans. The church worries, but the church, especially the local church, will have nothing to fear. Because the word of God says, I will build my church, and the gates of hell shall not prevail against us. Then we ask ourselves, why did God talk or worship at this time? But I'm forgetting what God will say. Precious in my sight is the death of my sins.
We may be wondering, why did God show us? Why did he reveal to us? I questioned myself. We were all the same year, the same month, we happened to come from the same geographical location. I was walking, I think it was in December. You know, I'm one of the members of this church in the diaspora. So occasionally I breathe in and I breathe out. So on that particular day, I never imagined, it never crossed my mind that I would be here standing in 0 miles from there to preach at the demands of the beloved brother. As I said in the tribute, how I wish I could have fixed my eyes, fixed my gaze on him, and that shows us that we are still mortal, we are limited. Why did God show us? Have we forgotten that God will not allow any man to share his glory? And the only reveals to us that past wants us to know, if he decides not to show something to us, that is nothing we can do about it. That is where the sovereignty of God comes in. I was going through a reading of the experience of a particular man. I would say he had a trance or he had a vision. And in his experience, he saw God coming closer and closer to him. It was as if he was dead and then he was face to face with God. And God was holding a briefcase. So when he saw God, and God was coming closer, he got elated and was asking, God, is that suitcase for me? Yes. God answered him, the suitcase is for you, but it's time for us to go. He said, go to here, I have so many miles. He said, sorry, time is up. You just have to go with me. He said, okay, I'll go with you, but what is it? That's my suitcase. God told me there are your belongings. He said, look, my clothes, my money, my shoe, my achievements, my attainment. He said, no, those ones, they belong to the heart. He said, okay, you have them, my memories. He said, my memories, they belong to time. What about my talent? Your talents, they belong to circumstances. They do not endure forever. Okay, he got two days, come on, that's what I'm going to talk about my friends and family. Said, your friends and family, they belong to the path which you travel while you are on this side of eternity. It was my wife and children. Oh, they belong to your hearts while you are here. So what about my body? Your body belongs to the dust. Okay? What about my soul? Your soul belongs to me, the Lord. Okay, give me the suitcase. This is said by the Lord. About to the suitcase, open the suitcase for me to find that it was empty. And then he started crying. So, Lord, what did me? I have nothing. He said, yes. The only thing you have is just a moment. And then the moment that you are going through, the next moment, you have control over it. He broke down. He said, no, I don't do nothing but just my moment. Therefore, every moment we have on this side of eternity, we should make the best out of it. Do not in every moment, as we all have for the successful. My dear brother, father, husband, uncle, and an elder in the church of God. For every moment you see her being good. Every moment, thank God. Every moment, realize that life is just a moment away. Living in Christ. Nothing for Christ.
in Christ, invest it in Christ. It's a mighty from verse 9 to 10. He says, the day for all that things are passed away is thy God. We spend a year as a tale that is told. The days of my years are 3 score years and 10. And if by reason of Christ, they become 4 years. Yes, he has great labor and sorrow. But it soon comes up and they fly away. I can tell you that the Lord Daddy, that doctor who needs a worship under two this principle very, very well. Therefore, he taught good and good men, he thanked God every moment, he lived that moment of Christ, he loved Christ, he entrusted Christ, and he invested in Christ to give God all the glory. The last part says, they will not only be blessed, they will not only bless for their neighbor, their works do for them. For what I worship, his works follow me, and his rewards are also following me. His years of godly existence, they follow me. He gave his life to Christ, he worked for Christ, he put in his best, he spent for Christ, he was spent for Christ. And for these years of godly existence, I'm sure the church has a testimony, I have a testimony, and have also a testimony. The years of service to humanity, his doctor, his servant, you know, praising to his brilliant two women. Okay? Praise the Lord. And what was there? His works that followed his service to humanity. We all knew the part he took internationally. Nobody naturally in the academic, he was a high flower. His years of servitude, they were works that followed him, both professionally and spiritually. His words and his rewards as a shepherd, he shepherded a lot. Even though he may not be referred to as a reverend gentleman, he did more than even the title. His reward and his works of years of divine faithfulness. He was faithful as his disciples, he was faithful as a church of God. That testimony to support this. His year followership, following Christ, following leadership. I remember very well. When my daddy was in the office as a general overseer, oh, just tell me, within the minute, whatever you wanted him to do, believe it was done. Very well, in his years of leadership, wasn't the time who would announce his arrival. He was silently walking behind the scene. And men and women, old and young, children, youth, every sphere of life, especially where we have the most general influence, we can all testify to this. The family also testify to this that as a father, as a leader, as a priest, as a king, as the authority of that home, he never failed in any aspect. And lastly, his years of friendship. I'm sure his wife can really testify about it. For one act in just a moment that he will just also continue to rest in peace. The challenge before you have just a moment, what are the works that will follow you? Shall we have? Father, we bless you, we just worship you for this time, short time of exaltation. Father, to rest with you. Accept the truth. Father, we pray, we grant each and every one of us the grace to follow and even to surpass. Not by might, not by heart, but just by your grace and spirit to do. In Jesus' precious name, we have prayed.
Praise the Lord. Thank you, the Holy Spirit of the Church. If we, for our healing, we want God, the man of our lives, the Lord, the Holy Spirit of the Church. Start with this.
Thank you.
And we are having our level 2 and pray for extended family and church.
Those projects will not suffer. Those expectations visions and visions will not suffer.
But God Almighty, clothe your back, take the area church with your glory and honor.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Financially, the other church will march on. Physically, you will march on. Spiritually, you will march on. In the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father, for giving us that devotion. Thank you, Father, for taking and giving at this time. Thank you, Lord. Glory and honor be unto you. Because of your good.
Thank you, sir. All call on our daddy in the Lord. Brother, Rose Babylon, to pray for the future family, the people's family of daddy.
To walk where there will be no darkness there, Where men shall we come on? Where sicknesses are then come on? Where the light shines continuously? And Father, Jesus is the light of that sea. And Father, it glows forever and ever. Where Father, there will be bursting forth an ecstasy of praise and joy. Where Father, angels sing sinless songs like as no end. Father, when we think of what you are preparing for us, you boldly declare to your beloved ones, say, let not your hand be troubled. Believe in God and believe also in the Lord Jesus Christ. For in his mother's house there are many mansions. Our dear beloved brother, our dear beloved father, our dear beloved husband, our dear beloved one amongst those who have distinguished himself, our dear beloved elder, I will go one and all, Father has finished, and I believe his house has been completed, and his keys have been handed over to him. It is we on this side of eternity that needs to now struggle on. And Father, march on dexterously without looking back. And may that by your special grace and honor and power, we shall meet to part no more. Therefore, Father, I pray for these seeds of his lungs that he has left behind, for these beloved relatives and beloved nucleus member of his family, whom Father, he has left for us as an example. That in the name of the Lord, they will not fail.
Amen.
God Almighty, you will keep them by your right hand.
Amen.
Behold the tie that none of them will pass by.
Amen.
None of them will meet that glorious meeting when they shall meet to part no more.
Amen.
None of them, Father, will have cause to put his fingers upon his mouth and bite it and say, at my father, at my husband, of my beloved uncle, of someone so dear to me, like whom he had been around, I would not have gone through this. Father, be a mighty pillar, by the back and by the left and right, in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Keep them to the very end.
Amen.
Your name will be glorified.
Amen.
We pray, Father, for members of the pastorate that work with the greatest charity. And Father, he has stood like a strong pillar within this church. Father, he speaks with glowing smile. And Father, with such ecstasy, Father, when he remembers that this is his church, when he comes to talk to me, he tells me we are being fun. Father, I will pray for these leaders who have walked together with him, who are even very close to me, like a brother. I will pray. In the name of the Lord, that you keep them strong, and when they meet on the streets of gold, they will burst into ecstasy in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
They are members of this family who look back and say, I have a group of people down over there. And Father, as he looks from the grandstand at this hour, and the finishing touches will be done tomorrow and next tomorrow. And Father, it's all over. Father, you will grant us to remain faithful until we see him face to face over there in the kingdom of our Lord, in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Thank you, Father. Blessed be the name of the Lord. We pray for you that each and every one of you so closely related to him as a nucleus member of our worship family. We ask that in the name of the Lord, you will not die before your time.
Amen.
No sickness will cut you short.
Amen.
You will fulfill the number of your
days.
Strong as there is God in heaven that rules over the affairs of men. Nothing. In need of the law or yet to be created or manufactured. Father, we'll be able to cut you short in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
We'll see the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living.
Amen.
You'll be well, you'll be strong. And as soon as the hour
the name of Jesus.
Amen.
However, at this moment, Father, while the pain still remains in their heart, and they know someone so beloved has gone, I plead the balm of Gilead will be applied at this hour and soothe your pains in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
I pray angels will wipe your tears.
Amen.
And in the name of the Lord, we know that it's for a transient moment. And soon, very soon, we will need to fight no more.
Amen.
And in the name of the Lord, until then, we encourage one another. The scripture says, in the book of 1 Thessalonians, chapter 4, verse 18, we encourage you and us with these words that we will need to fight no more.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Go in peace, and the God of peace goes.
Yeah.
All those who are not here, Father, may these blessings follow them.
Amen.
Those who are bad, Father, may you comfort them.
Amen.
Those who are not bad, may heaven bring them joy of sweet assurance. As soon as they took and told the pathway which our dear doctor will now worship to the Father, they too will see him in glory.
Amen.
Thank you for the church. And the church will continue to march on.
Amen.
And it's a bear that will not prevail against you. You will see goodness and mercy of the Lord. Post even this faith of our dear brother. Because the Bible says, let me see that it cannot multiply. I hope that this incident will lead to increase and multiplication in all these ramifications. In the name of Jesus,
Amen.
It shall be well with you. Go in peace. And everyone of you here, and those who are by extension, this prayer is meant, but let the peace of God go before them,
Amen.
And go after them,
Amen.
And sustain them,
Amen.
And continue to comfort you with great joy.
Amen.
I already pray, Father, for the pastor of this local church. Father, and many others who have walked in so close intimacy with him, closer than a brother. He said, there's a brother, there's someone who's closer than a brother to each and every one of us, and his name is Jesus. Take the rightful place in their hearts.
Amen.
And Father, continue the soothing balm of healing to be sufficient for them in times like this.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord. In Jesus' wonderful name, we have prayed.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Amen. Praise Lord, I want to thank God for the ritual of this night. We lifted in the mighty name of Jesus. Previous to some announcements, I want to make some announcements. The funeral service arrangements, funeral arrangements continue as follows. The word of God is the 16th of July, 2020. The commendation service will be taking place at First Square Gospel Church, number 5, the land of Shima in the street, Ajam, Lagos, at 4 p.m. At 4 p.m. Let us watch, we'll be watching that through www.olugumiaboshom.com. Then on Friday, we have a beautiful service retirement that will be taking place at Donors and Guidance, Koyi, Lagos, at 10 a.m. Praise the Lord. For those of you that can't be there, if you join the activities there, the website www.olugumiaboshom.org. Praise the Lord. And for those of us who are new here, I don't know if there's anybody that is new, you are welcome to the Sanctuary of Grace, Gather Tech, First of all, the church. This is number 15, the little people street, Abuja Church. This is where God reigns. This is where God reigns. And in compliance with the COVID-19 directive that the federal government, we are still on virtual services and meetings. So for Sundays, our services starts at 8 a.m. via Zoom, the Zoom platform, which is normally sent out. Then on Tuesdays at 6 p.m., we have our prayer meetings. And on Thursdays at 6 p.m., we have our Bible studies. Please endeavor to join and be blessed. Praise the Lord. I'm going to be talking about taking goodness fully and video to take the Lord of Christ. Thank you.
Praise the Lord. And all is good. Praise the Lord. In everything about soul should be thanks. And that's exactly what we are here to do. To appreciate God for taking him to rest. Like Paul said, for me to live is Christ and to die is gain. To die is rest. Praise the Lord. I stand here on behalf of the family to give this vote of thanks. And first and foremost, we want to appreciate God the Almighty, who is faithful, is good, and that is why he's God. For today, because we are celebrating life, amen. Praise the Lord. So, we give him the glory for his faithfulness concerning his life, his family, his ministry, and for taking him to his side, and for making today possible, for giving us beautiful weather. We thank him. We also want to appreciate the Prosper family and leadership for the support given, the support is quite overwhelming. In all gratification, I would say thank you to Prosper organization and the leadership to start with our daddy, Reverend Dr. Wisdom Adeo Bombadejo. Permit me to mention your name respectfully, sir. We appreciate you. You've been a father, and you are still a father, and you are our father. The Lord will bless you. The Lord will affect everything that concerns you, and the Lord will bless you and bless all that connects with you in Jesus' name. Likewise, we have our mommy in the house. Our mommy, our spiritual mommy, and the wife of our daddy, our mommy, Reverend Sisika Badejo, is our mommy in the house, our spiritual mommy. To me, she's a double mommy. You'll be wondering why. She's my spiritual mommy, and she is my school mother. I never had the opportunity to meet in school. Praise the Lord. There is no one who made the grace to meet him because of the Instagram. So, you are welcome, ma. You have been so wonderful, you are involved indeed. And by the grace of God, the Lord will continue to prosper you in Jesus' name. It is worthy of note to say at this time that our daddy and mommy, Badly Job, were missionaries for the Badly Harvest program. And by the grace of God, the Lord continued to expand the program, and we count it as righteousness for you in the mighty name of Jesus. At the same time, we want to appreciate our daddy in the house and the person of Reverend Roland Okereke. Praise the Lord. He's the district overseer of the Prosper Gospel Church, and I like to speak. You are welcome, sir. Thank you so much. God bless you. and uphold your ministry in Jesus' name. Amen. Likewise, we have a daddy and the person of Reverend Joe Amen. Praise the Lord. He's the industry secretary of Prosper Gospel Church, Alaka, the state, and the chairman, governing council of the Prosper Gospel Church in Nigeria. Praise the Lord. Be the friend of the house. He appreciates you. He said, thank you. God bless you. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
So, like I said, it's the chairman of the council of life. I hope you know what life is in Prosper. It means Life House of International Prosper Evangelism. Praise the Lord. It's a Bible college, and I believe to become a university soon. Praise the Lord. At the same time, I want to appreciate among the house. The person of Reverend Mrs. Clara Akeni. Thank you so much, ma'am. She's coming in the house. And the wife of her daddy, Reverend Akeni, who will have been here for some other assignments. They are the Reverend Akeni Akeni. District overseer of the Prosper Gospel Church, Ajah district. You are welcome, ma'am. Please extend our appreciation to him. Thank you, God bless. Also, we have to be greeting the Prosper family members. We also have another family in the Lord. We are all one in Christ. Whether for square or again, we have the person of Dr. Abubakar Olashedi. He's a living pastor. And he happens to be the deputy rector of academics when I had a workshop with the rector of the college. He specifically requested to be part of this program, which shows relationship. We should build relationship. We really appreciate you, sir. God bless you. And bless your ministry and your family in Jesus. Also, we recognize our mommy in the house, in the person of our dear mommy, the senior pastor of this noble church, and that is our mommy, Reverend Mrs. Gladys Adeniyi. Together with the pastorates, we have Pastor Adani, Pastor Dele Oshawa in the house. We have Pastor Winter and Pastor Sweet and Pastor Winter. We are all welcome. Thank you so much. And other pastors, even who are not yet recognized. And the entire church, the church council, and the members, every member of the church, you have a wonderful. We thank you and God bless you. Thank God for what He has made us a happy, big family. And that's what we shall continuously be. The glory of God by His grace. Amen. At this point, I want to recognize our only Elder Yamisho Sade, praise the Lord. The IFPC PRO, the only wish of nobody in this. I believe we all know him. Thank you for raising time to back to us. We appreciate God. Let's reach in Jesus' name. And want to appreciate the family. The represented by the children here, that is Shayo and our husband, Pastor Adeniyi. We also have behind the house, and Lady Fraser. We are the children of our great daddy and they represent the family. We appreciate you for being part of this program, even though the program is the distance is far, but the love is near. So we send our appreciation to the entire family. We love and appreciate you. Jesus' name. And we want to appreciate every member of this noble church. Everybody has been so wonderful. If not for this season that we are in, everybody wishes to come. But we must work in obedience, and that's why they are not able to make it. Because we believe that they are linking up and they are watching this program. We appreciate you all, even though we are not able to make it, but we are together in spirit. May the Lord bless you and uphold you all in the mighty name of Jesus. We want to appreciate everyone that has made it possible for us to go this program. Everybody has contributed in one way or the other, and we really want to extend appreciation to you. And good Lord will appreciate each and every one of us. The Lord bless you and the Lord prosper your ways. Thank you so much. God bless you. Can I enter like anybody out? Please call me. God knows you all and he appreciates you. God bless you.
Thank you for your forgiveness. I wish I had not the voice in my heart to praise the Lord. Before we call on our doctor, so in the person of our ruler, to pay him, we are going to call the Tony Hill, call the fire, take Tony Hill, one son, the two, through the Lord.
We thank you, God, for the fine weather. Thank you, God, for the peace in the land. Thank you, God, who have been with us since the beginning of this program this evening to this moment. We are grateful and thankful to you, God, that we are exalted in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Lord God Almighty, we commit, O God, going out of this place into the heavens. I pray, O God, that you continue to keep us and watch over us. No evil shall befall us in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. I pray, O God, none of us will walk from sorrow to sorrow in the mighty name of Jesus. That what you have done today, O God, do much more tomorrow. Do much more, O God, on Friday, in the mighty name of Jesus. I ask, O God, for fine weather tomorrow, fine weather next tomorrow, in the mighty name of Jesus. We ask, O God, for your peace tomorrow, and we ask for your peace next tomorrow, and continually your peace to reign and reign in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, God, for hearing, and the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the sweet fellowship of the Holy Spirit. Rest and abide with us now and forevermore. Amen. Surely, God's goodness and mercy shall follow us all the days of our life, and we shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever. Amen. Thank you. God bless you all.